Hi guys, Sean here from DigiDirect. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Pentax K3 Mark III. This is a new APS-C DSLR from Pentax. It's an update to the K3 Mark II, which came out in 2015. Now, these days we're not seeing as many new DSLR models coming out, as most manufacturers are putting more of their focus on their mirrorless ranges, but there are still quite a few people who prefer shooting with a DSLR, and as we'll see, the K3 Mark III still has quite a few tricks up its sleeve. Now let's start by taking a look at the body design of the camera. So as we can see, this is a fairly standard body design. It's heavily influenced by the K3 Mark II. Being a higher end camera, we have quite a few premium features on here, including weather sealing, dual SD card slots, a joystick controller, a top LCD panel, a touch screen with new touch menus, by the way, and just a generally premium feel to the build quality of the camera. We've got a new dial on the top here, which iterates on the function dial from the Mark II. It allows you to adjust which setting it's going to change for more customization. The grip here is very solid and chunky, and the camera also has mic, headphone, HDMI, and USB-C ports. One big feature here is the new viewfinder. This is a pentaprism with 105% magnification, which is actually the largest ever on an APS-C DSLR. It's also 10% brighter than on the Mark II. Overall, this is a fantastic viewfinder, and if optical viewfinders are one of the reasons why you prefer shooting with DSLRs, this is a great selling point on this one. In my testing with the camera, I used the 40mm f2.8 pancake lens, which made the whole package super small and portable, as you can see. Now, two slightly surprising points about the physical design is that the screen is not articulating, which would have been nice for handheld video shooters or someone shooting from a tripod. Also, there is no external battery charger in the box. You charge the battery while it's in the camera via USB. The battery is rated for 800 shots per charge, but I use this camera for days before having to recharge it, so it's got a very solid battery life. You can also get a battery grip, the DBG8, to hold a second battery. Inside the camera is a 25.7 megapixel APS-C sensor. That's a good mid-range resolution. There's a lot of detail in that, but it's not so high res that you're going to have huge image file sizes coming out of the camera, which is nice. There's also no anti-aliasing filter on the camera, which is going to result in sharper images, and the sensor can do 14-bit readout at up to 12 frames per second. So you're getting a lot of very high quality images out of the camera. You can see the detail here is very good from the images shot here. Also, the low light performance is improved. It has better low light performance than the Pentax KP. There's also a new processor in here, which allows it to shoot better in low light environments. You can see here, I was shooting between ISO 6400 and even 25,600 on the high end, and these are pretty good results for those high ISOs. Finally, if you do want extra resolution, that you do have the pixel shift mode, which is going to take four separate images and combine them into one ultra high resolution image. Like many Pentax cameras before it, the K3 Mark III has 5-axis in-body image stabilization built into the camera. This covers 5.5 stops of stabilization, which is one stop better than the K3 Mark II does. This is going to be a great feature both for photographers and videographers alike. For photographers, this is going to allow you to shoot handheld at much lower shutter speeds, which is going to improve your low light shooting. It also even allows you to, as you can see here, I shot these waterfall shots completely handheld, so I was able to shoot at a slow enough shutter speed, I think it was about a third or a fourth of a second, in order to get that nice motion blur without having to use a tripod, so that's really handy. For videographers, obviously, handheld video shooting is going to be much more stable than if you didn't have the IBIS. It means you can do, you know, stationary positions, handheld, that look like they're on a tripod, panning, even walking motions are all going to be a lot smoother. So it's an important feature, and it's very well implemented here. In terms of autofocus, the K3 Mark III has a 101-point AF system. This uses a new autofocus module, the SafeOx 13 module, which has 20% wider coverage than the SafeOx 11 module, which was on the K3 Mark II. You can also focus at up to -4 EV, so in low light conditions, as long as you're using a lens that is at least f2.8. There's also updated algorithms for the continuous AF, which are going to make it better at recognizing faces, birds, and other subjects. And the camera can shoot at 12 frames per second or 11 frames per second if you're using continuous AF. There's also an updated shutter mechanism in here, which is going to reduce viewfinder blackout. So in practice, it's a very good system. I was quite pleased with the results. It's fast, it's responsive, it's quite reliable, not a lot of errors on it. So if you're shooting anything with, you know, moving subjects and so on, it does quite a good job. You can also use the joystick on the back to move your AF point quite easily. And if you're in live view mode, you can use the touchscreen to use touch AF. Looking at video, the K3 Mark III can shoot 4K video at up to 30 frames per second, which is actually a first for a K-mount camera. So video shooters have a lot to play with here. You can see here from the video footage that I've shot, it's very crisp, it's very sharp, a lot of detail. I really like the look of the video. It's really quite nice. There's also the mic and headphone jack on the camera, so using an external microphone to capture your audio is very easy. As I mentioned before, the in-body image stabilization is a big deal here. I shot all of the footage when I was testing the camera completely handheld. I never felt the need to go onto a tripod because the IBIS was just solid enough that I just never really needed it. The only drawback to video is that lack of the articulating screen. There were a few times where I was holding the camera shooting with it and I didn't necessarily have it at eye level. Maybe it was at my chest because I was walking around like this or something, and I wished I could have flipped the screen out and tilted it up to me. It's not a huge gripe, it's not gonna, you know, kill the camera for you. It would have been nice though, but other than that, video performance on this camera is quite good. Overall, the Pentax K3 Mark III is a very well performing camera and a solidly built body that is intelligently designed. A lot of great premium features on here, the dual card slots and so on. You've got very good image quality, 5.5 stops of IBIS, a solid AF system, and 4K video. Now, being a DSLR, I don't think it's necessarily going to convert someone who's already gone to mirrorless and not to come back to DSLR, probably not. But for someone who has some K-mount lenses already and they want to continue getting use out of them, this is a great purchase. Also, if you own the K3 Mark II, this is a solid upgrade to that as well. Now, you can purchase the Pentax K3 Mark III on our website at www.digidirect.com.au, or if you want to come in the store, chat with our staff about it, they can give you a physical in-person tour of the camera. We've got stores in the Sydney CBD, Bondi Junction, Miranda, the Brisbane and Melbourne CBD, and Cannington, Western Australia, which is just outside the Perth CBD. Thanks, guys. Take care.